Going through some fairly easy one-mark questions. Julia inputs personal data into her computer. She stores 3 copies of the data using a hard disk drive, a solid-state drive, and a USB flash memory drive. Identify 3 devices Julia can use to input personal data into her computer. If you hit a blank on these type of questions, try to use as much information from the question as you can. The question has told us that Julia is inputting data into her computer. So you want to think of a computer setup. What does a computer setup consist of? When we're using a computer, the main thing that we're probably looking at is our display or the monitor. However, that is an output device. Here we want input devices. When we're using a computer, the most common methods that we'd use to input data would be using a keyboard, using a mouse, and perhaps if you're using a touchscreen laptop or a tablet, you may use touchscreen. A few other answers could be a microphone. She could be audibly entering personal data. She could also use a keypad and perhaps a touchpad, which is what laptops use as a mouse. The next question says, Magda has a mobile telephone. She uses the touchscreen on her telephone to send emails to her customers. The touchscreen breaks, stopping Magda from using it to type her emails. Identify one other input device that would be built into the mobile telephone that Magda could use to send an email to her customers. Again, if we had a blank with this, we want to use everything within this question. Here we know that we're speaking about a mobile telephone. So think about what a mobile telephone looks like, and you should be able to figure out that we have a microphone. The touchscreen operates by using the conductive properties of the object that is used to touch the screen. State whether the touchscreen is resistive, capacitive, or infrared touchscreen. Taking a look at the resistive touchscreen, let's draw a diagram to explain how this works. This is a side view of a resistive touchscreen. With a resistive touchscreen, we have 2 thin layers. When the layers connect at a certain point, we're able to track the X and Y coordinates of exactly where it is pressed. So, for example, if you press down on our touchscreen, the top layer depresses at a certain point and connects with the second layer. This completes the circuit, and we have now pressed down on the resistive touchscreen. Looking at capacitive, capacitive touchscreens are made up of a glass layer and an electrode pattern layer. This electrode pattern layer forms an electric field above it. When your finger presses down on the capacitive screen, there is a very small change in current at that point, and a microprocessor is able to detect where that change in capacitance is using this electrode layer. Finally, the infrared touchscreen has a grid of infrared lasers above the screen. On the sides, we have phototransistors, which detect when light has changed. When someone presses down on the surface, the infrared beams are obstructed, and the phototransistors will detect this, which will give the XY position where the user has pressed. In this case, they've told us that the touchscreen operates by using the conductive properties of the object that is used to touch the screen. The object being used to touch the screen is the finger. With capacitive, your finger changes the electric field as it presses down on the screen. Hence, the answer to this is capacitive. Magda is listening to music on her mobile telephone when she receives a telephone call. A signal is sent within the telephone to stop the music and output that a call has been received. Give the name of this type of signal. So, you don't want to confuse this type of signal with things like radio waves or microwaves, or even analog or digital signals. Here, we're speaking about a signal that is sent within the telephone. And the purpose of the signal is to stop the music and tell Magda that a call has been received. This relates to the CPU, hence the answer to this is going to be an interrupt. Next question. A train company wants to install a self-service ticket machine system for its train stations. When the customer has purchased their tickets, the machine will provide a paper ticket. One output device that is used in the ticket machine is a display screen. Identify one other output device that is used in the ticket machine system. Again, if you get stuck on this type of question, you want to use whatever they've given you and try to visualize the system whilst it's being used. If it helps, try to visualize yourself doing this action of getting a ticket using a ticket machine. What is the process you use to get a ticket? You go up to the ticket machine, You enter in your details using a keypad or touchscreen. You can see all of this on the display screen. At the end, your ticket is printed out. Hence, the answer here is going to be a printer. Other answers that could be accepted would be a speaker. There could be audio directions from the ticket machine that could tell you what to do. You could also have a light or an LED which tells you if you've done the correct action. Or you could even have an actuator, which is going to activate when the ticket is ready and will push the ticket out. Question B says, the train company does not want users to use a keyboard or a mouse to enter their data when buying a ticket. The company is worried that they may be stolen or get too dirty. Identify one other input device that would be suitable for use in the ticket machine system to allow users to enter their data. So again, we want to try and visualize what this looks like. We aren't allowed to use a keyboard or a mouse. The other type of input device we've already discussed over here would be a touchscreen. You can be fairly creative with your answer for this question. You could answer things like QR codes, microphone, barcode readers, RFID readers. There's quite a few answers for this type of question, as it is fairly open-ended. But there we go, that is those three questions completed.